In question 16, a block is submerged in a vessel filled with water by a spring attached to the bottom of the vessel as shown. In equilibrium, the spring is compressed. The vessel is now speeds up in the downward direction with an acceleration A which is less than g. You have to find out the length of the spring now. Dear student, let us draw the free body diagram of this block or mass. There will be a downward mg force. There will be a spring force upward kx and a buoyancy b upwards. Now dear student, initial this is the condition and we can write down that b plus kx will be equal to mg, where b is actually equal to rho vl into g, that is the volume of the body multiplied by the density of the liquid multiplied by g. Now from this we can write down that kx will be equal to g m minus v rho l. Now finally we can write down that mg minus b dash plus kx dash is equal to ma, as both x dash and b dash will change. So from here b dash is equal to v rho l g minus a. On substituting this we get a value of kx dash to be equal to g minus a m minus v rho l. Now let us compare this equation and this equation. We can clearly see that x dash is coming out to be less than x, so compression will be less, and because the compression is less, the length of the spring will increase. Meaning for this question the correct answer is option number 1. Now let us solve the question number 17. In question number 17 there are 4 options given related to streamline motion. We have to find out which of them is correct. The student, among these the third option is correct, which says that the velocity of all fluid particles crossing a given position is constant. That is option number 3. In a streamline motion, when a particle crosses a given point in space, its velocity is same. That is, at a given point in space, all the particles crossing that point have same velocity. This makes the option number 3 for this question the correct answer. Now let us move to the question number 18. In this question, the glycerin flows steadily through a horizontal tube of length 1 meter and radius 1 centimeter. If the amount of glycerin collected per second at one end is 3.75 into 10 to the minus 3 kg per second, the pressure difference between the two ends of the tube is. Now dear student, as per the Poiseuille's formula, the rate of flow, that is dV by dt, where V is the volume, is given as pi p r4 by 8 eta L. Now dV by dt will be equal to dm by dt divided by the density rho. And this will be equal to 3.75 into 10 raised to power minus 3, and rho is 1.25 into 10 raised to power 3 as given in the equation. This will be 3 into 10 raised to power minus 6 meter cube per second. Now pi p r 4 by 8 eta l will be equal to 3 into 10 raised to power minus 6, which gives us p to be equal to, if we substitute the given values, because r is given as 1 centimeter, l is given as 1 meter, eta, that is viscosity, is also given. The pressure turns out to be equal to 611 pascals. Meaning for this question, the correct answer is option 2. Now let us proceed to the question number 19. In question 19, which of the following is correct for the modulus of elasticity of copper? Dear student, this is a factual based question. The Young's modulus for copper is 110 into 10 raised to power 9 Newton per meter square, while the bulk modulus is 140 into 10 raised to power 9 Newton per meter square. We can clearly see that the bulk modulus is greater than the Young's modulus, and hence for this question the correct answer is option number 1. Moving on to the question number 20. Question 20 says the area of cross section of a large tank is 1 meter square. It has a small opening of cross-sectional area 1 cm square near the bottom. A load of 40 kg is applied at the water at the top. The speed of the water coming out of the opening at the time when the height of the water level is 1 meter above the bottom is nearly. Now student, let us draw a diagram. This is the tank. And at the bottom there is a small opening of area 1 cm square. Now at the top, a load of 40 kg is applied. The height of the water is 1 meter. Now dear student, we can apply the Bernoulli's theorem at 1 and 2 and write down that P naught plus mg by A, that is the pressure at 1, plus rho gh will be equal to P naught plus half rho v square. Now this is the pressure at 1 and this is the pressure and the kinetic energy per unit volume at 2. We can see that P naught and P naught will get cancelled, and on substituting the values we write 40 into 10 by 1 plus 10 raised to power 3 plus 10 into 1 is equal to half into 1000, that is the density of water, into V square. On solving this we get a value of V to be equal to root of 20.8, that is approximately equal to 4.6 meter per second, meaning that for this question the correct answer is option 2. Now let us proceed to the question number 21.